Nestled in the heart of the San Juan Mountains is the idyllic western town of Durango, famous for its Durango and Silverton narrow gauge railroad and the Victorian landmark, the Strater Hotel.
We want every local in this town to feel like this is their hotel. We figure that there are approximately 2 million people that have been served by the Strater that are alive today. And the Strater is everything about culture, about architecture, about design, values. And so when they come to Durango, they've come to a place that's going to share with them the culture of this community and of Southwest Colorado.
In 1887, Henry Strater built his Red and White Majesty for a mere $70,000. Its cornices and windowsills are elaborately carved from white sandstone.
A lot of the early people, when it was finally built, would come down here in the wintertime, the people that lived in Durango, and close their houses because of the cold weather and move to the Strater.
The Strater Hotel is a journey back to yesteryear. Victorian heirlooms adorn every room. There are antique-filled shadow boxes, leaded glass chandeliers, and intricately carved headboards. There's even hand-stenciled wallpaper on the ceiling. Furnishings not antique, such as those in the Spiratorium and all queen-size beds, are handcrafted by a local woodworker.
So what we've done over 119 years has evolved the interior of the hotel to the period that it was designed in originally, but with the money that they didn't have at that time. We have the largest collection of American Victorian walnut antiques.
For over 80 years, three generations of the Barker family have owned and managed the stately Strater Hotel.
My grandfather, when he talked about this hotel to my dad, said, "Son, if you will always take care of this hotel, it will take care of you as well." Well, my mom and dad really had a vision of creating an entire environment that would attract people.
I think the biggest influence was my mother, and she had Victorian furniture in a Victorian home in Durango. And she said that she thought this would be perfect here, which it was.
They went to Atlanta to a hotel show one time, and my mom found some beautiful antique furniture, one with a half-teaster bed that was spectacular. And they said, "Gosh, what if we did this in the hotel and put some of this antique furniture in the hotel?" Some of the furniture that we have in one room, over $100,000 worth of walnut American Victorian antiques.
And in fact, most of the furniture that we got in the South was there during the Civil War. But when I started doing the decor, my husband and his brother-in-law were doing everything. They ran the bar and the front desk and the restaurant. They were decorating the rooms, and their theory of decoration was to paint one wall brown, one wall yellow, and one wall green. And then no matter what bedspread was put in, it would all match. So when I was elected, it was either the housekeeper or me. I just became fascinated with it.
A popular hangout for both cowboy locals and tourists is the Diamond Bell Saloon.
When people come in, they really are like transfixed and they feel they're back in that era. We do a lot of the music from the early 1900s, a lot of ragtime.
The Diamond Bell Saloon was built in 1957. My grandfather was approached by my dad, who said, "Gosh, we should put in a bar." And my grandfather said, "Absolutely not."
He and my mother went to Hawaii for a trip, and while they were gone, we built the Diamond Bell.
And I guess my dad thought forgiveness was easier than permission, and my grandfather thought it was his idea all along.
One of the things that has made it so popular is the fact that Louis L'Amour, the Western writer, was in 222, which is room just above the Diamond Bell. The sound from the rinky-tink piano would sort of come up in the, and Louis would have his front windows open so he could hear the piano, and that would set him off, and you could hear his typewriter upstairs going, and Louis just loved it.
When people travel to Durango, what I really want for them to feel is the sense of the spirit of the hotel. And I want them to leave a little something too, because this hotel is a part of that spirit of each person. In every room in the hotel, there's a little book on the bed. And that book is a collection of stories that people have written about their stay.
We all had tears in our eyes reading them. They were so emotionally written, pour out their souls of what they think of the hotel. We think we've accomplished what we set out.
So being different is what we're all about, and I think people respond to that. A real hotel is about human drama. We allow people to fulfill their dreams. That's what a historic hotel brings out.